All right, folks, here it is, the throwback race using the Darlington throwback cars from NASCAR, and we're throwing back to the most glorious, worst day in SCARTS history, the best day in SCARTS history, where REIROM won the Daytona 500, and in his honor, this is the Me Am Winner 411, with 11 ghosts of REIROM's number 11 car scattered throughout the track. And all of us are in the REIROM spirit. I'm going to make sure to beef as many people as possible the whole race. That right us. Kind of hoping to get past with Arson and Shemek, but. Silva crashes burnout, which is a lucky break for Oompa, who had said his start fuel was something funny. It was not a not a good choice. But it ended up being perfect timing since Silva crashed right then. We'll go with it. Then wasn't perfect, but it worked. And everybody's together and basically in the same position as we started in, so we can roll with it. some cheeky moves here. In the past, when I've kind of been too committed to pushing people or whatever, so I'm gonna try to kind of just run my own thing, not be too unwilling to push, but also not be too unwilling to make moves, even if it's early on. His laps led basically doesn't mean anything for this race for anybody. Because I've already clinched the regular season title, and I think basically everybody else is stuck in their points position, so it's not going to matter either way. Points don't matter. All about getting that win. Silva and Chimek can both, they're both in must-win situations to make the playoffs. Both of them win and they're in, don't and they're out. Rest of us are just fighting for that extra point. I don't know what Chimek's doing. Straight. A little sketchy. Four wide at the line there. I was the only one who got the push, so I led the lap. And that's kind of hanging with me on the outside. Situations. I think the outside's the place to be, but the inside, even if you're not pushing like they are, you can steal the draft off the guys on the outside and that makes it so you don't have to be as well organized, but you can keep up the same speed. The outside's definitely the faster area. We've been able to keep ahead for the most part the last few laps. I wonder how long Burnout's gonna hold with me. As long as he is, I'm just gonna hang out up here if he's committed. It doesn't really matter for either of us who leads laps. In the past, whenever we've raced here, it's been about every point, every position, but we're both just kind of racing for the win so we can help each other out a little bit more than we usually have in the past. And try to settle between the two of us. Burnout and I have had a lot of duels throughout the years, but never really at Daytona or Talladega, because we end up not really helping each other because we're battling each other in points, so we have to we end up not really one or the other of us can make a move, but usually not both like we have at pretty much every other track we've raced at. We're not got cut off by arson there, and then they all kind of got slowed, so a bit separated for a bit here. Arson's not pushing. Shemek almost took out Burnout there. It's harder to read chat with everybody as REIROMs, because you're like, you have to look really closely to see exactly which of the REIROMs it is. Got a bit of a double push there with Oompa sliding up. Sort of gave his speed to Burnout, and their combined push went to me. Oompa's pitting. Guess he must have been short filled or something. I don't know. It's been off strategy since the start of the race. Those. I guess they're gonna keep going with it. So now we're split into two groups of two and then two single car groups. Shemek was running kind of low before. I guess he might be worried about lag, so I don't know. If I could talk to him, I'd say to just go ahead and pass me, and then I'll push. He's got the tire advantage, so I'm not quite catching him yet. We will be pretty soon. That's definitely faster up top. just go stay like a lane off the wall. Is this both buffer room? Especially if there's any lag whenever we make contact. There, he kind of hit me at a bad time. So he had to get out of the gas to make sure he was still good. Looks like Burnout and Arson are catching us. I think they're being a little bit more aggressive on the line. Be right next to the wall if he can be, but I'm taking sort of the compromise line here to keep us both safe. I'm just surprised we haven't caught Oompa. Yeah, there's the tire advantage, but I didn't realize it was that severe. I have to pit this time. Burnout got a little screwed there. Just gonna hurt Arson. Slid down just a hair to make sure Shima could catch me. If that splits us from Arson, then that'll probably be best, although it also wouldn't surprise me if Shima could yeah, he's holding up to get Arson back in, which is fair. Oh, I thought I crashed myself there. Too busy looking back. What else is going on? G-Mech's not drafting with me. I'm going to be a little bit more aggressive on my line. Give me a few extra laps led. closer to Silva here. Definitely changed the dynamic a bit. Chivek was giving way, but I intentionally hit him so that we could keep green. Together. That's still a good ways back. Wonder if he did something funky strategy-wise. So we're kind of in the area where you can maybe do something on fuel. I think it's way too far out to plan anything, because I think what it's going to end up being is if it goes green from here, everybody will have to pit with like 10 laps to go or something like that, and so you can just kind of short fuel. But I typically don't like to mess around with that stuff in advance, because if you're short fueling and you're doing it early, then that means you're kind of if you're short fueling and doing it early, then you're running with extra fuel for a lot more laps than you would if you just run it straight out. So I don't like to mess with that kind of strategy. But if Burnout had like hit the wall and he was running by himself anyway, if he could do that and then get locked up with somebody, which it looks like he has because we're catching up to him and Oompa right now, if you can do that, then you can potentially I'm trying to pass him there, I just kind of misaligned my push. If you can do something like that, then you can get to the point where you're ahead at pit stop, but I don't think there's much of a situation where that's really going to help you, because we're still catching Burnout because we're lined up. few laps, they might have saved more fuel, in which case they might go an extra lap. If that happens, it would be ideal, but I can make it work. It's the delta on old tires versus new tires is enough with the current setup that you can get away with that. I was trying to tell him, and then I second guessed myself, and then I unsecond guessed myself. So I fucked that up. So we're still going to be 8 laps shorter or whatever here with burnout. I guess they must have ran out of fuel, so I did that right. I was typing it, and then I looked up and saw 1.3 laps or something like that, and I was like, oh, I got another lap. And then I was like, oh, no shit, that means that I'm not going to have enough to get it from. I was going to be a quarter of a lap short or whatever, so I just kind of last second turned across the field pit. Was not trying to do anything sneaky, just kind of fucked up. So now that means burnout's going to be the lucky dog if we get a caution. Then Silva, they might be on the lead lap, hard to tell. Noticeably slower. I don't know if he's not taking tires or what, but you could just tell he's getting bogged down when I pushed him. Burnout's just gonna hang with me. Sort of his best position is to just go as fast as he can with me. If he gets a caution, then he's in the catbird seat. If he doesn't, then he's going faster than he would if he was trying to race me, so. Either way, there's no real benefit in racing the leader unless there are multiple people racing the leader on the same lap. If you're just one lap down, then there's no reason. He's save fuel or something. Someone's been having some issues keeping the car straight, so I didn't want to push them. Push burnout though, I don't really care. This is trying some funky fuel save and shit. To go. Maybe 6 laps short on fuel. Now I've got a decent lead over Arson and Shimek because I'm assuming they ran out of fuel judging by the chat once they were pitting. Let me put on intervals here so I can scoreboard so I can see what's going on. Yes, they're 16 seconds back, which is like 3/4 of a lap down. So that's not anything that they can make up with 1 or 2 laps worth of fuel in the pit stop. Gonna play it straightforward here. Line that up very well. Save a little bit of fuel then. Just trying to stay away from the wall while Silva was hanging out down there. Could theoretically save a little bit of fuel and then make it like 1 extra lap, but I don't think it's worth the risk because burnout's gonna have to pit, I assume, before I do. Just gonna slow down my lap time. I think I can just play it safe. It's not going to really make a difference either way, I don't think. Plus, it's too late to make that decision. I got 10 laps to go. I got 3 laps until I'm going to have to pit. All right. Larson and Schumacher pitting this lap. So I don't have to worry about them spending less time than me. Also means that I've got everybody a lap down at this point. I've got a pit here. Seven laps to go, that's up to like 33%. Myself more buffer since I'm not in the draft. It'd suck if that came to bite me. I got gap as well in hand. I gave myself, I think, a couple extra laps worth, so I should be okay. Seven laps, yeah, five laps. As long as we don't get a caution and I don't screw it up. Got this in the bag. This is the last lap we can call a caution and still finish the race. Caution ends it at this point, so I'm good. Still got a huge lead on everybody. I feel bad that the race-winning move was basically me forgetting to what I was doing, not typing pit, and kind of hung out Schumacher and Larson, but I really wasn't trying to. That will be fitting that since I finished second to REIROM in the REItona 500 that he won, that I'll be the winner here for the Me Am Winner 411. Get my first win on the Daytona Oval. Nice. To do donuts on REIROM here. Since he was the one who took away my first good attempt at a Daytona win. And now I finally get one. Actually, let me park next to REIROM's ghost. Nice. Glad to finally get one at Daytona, REItona. So I guess Schumach and Harson, they both kind of, I guess they must have caught together going into the pits, and then that slowed them down enough that they lost their momentum and couldn't make it on no fuel. So that was pretty much the cause of it. It's a huge 21-second victory margin for Daytona. But yeah, that was, finally got one done here at Daytona, REItona, in memory of REIROM, 2013 to 2015 or whenever the fuck it was we ended up banning him. But RIP REIROM, and thanks for watching. See you next time.